tan one has a hard time with his teeth.
Yeah, I think it's actually that tongue. So he's on the to-do
list. Oh, yes.
Yeah, he's the one that's got that weird.
I forgot about that.
Is that that thing on the side, like it scoops around his tooth?
Yeah, yeah. It's really weird.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's a growth, I don't know if it's a tumor, I don't know what that is. It doesn't really look like an injury that didn't heal. Like, I don't know, I've got a few different theories, but I'm worried about what it might be. Because I know how fast it works on meal. Mm-hmm. I wonder how dramatic of a difference it can see, good or bad, in his attitude.
That might be
one of those careful what you wish for scenarios.
Thank you.
Much more open space. The dogs like it so much better.
Yeah.
So I found that there's so much more calm here overall than you are.
So much easier to walk them.
It's when they're available, and most of the time they're not. Like right now, we have Katie and Jenna here. She's only 21 pounds, but probably like four of that is the mass that she's carrying. It's like a baseball, well, the softball size. So she's gonna have, yeah. So you can go and sit with her. She's a nice little dog. There's shelters you're removing it, and they've already done because it's in her mammary tumor, so it is most likely breast cancer. But in dogs, it's very different than it is in people. They remove the mammary tumor, you know, where the masses are, and that's it. It's gone. So, but yeah, so she's had it for a while. It looks like she came in as a mammary surrounded, and so the shot will be taken out. It's supposed to happen last week. But they've already done like the chest X-ray to make sure that they didn't metastasize or anything. Yeah, and she's good. So.
So
Zinnia looks the way Sapphire did about 6 weeks ago. So they're both valley fever dogs, but she came in the same shape that she was
problems
in.
Here.
And
allergies,
we're
probably
really hopeful that now that she's
so
on the proper meds and everything, that she'll start, you know, gaining weight. And
this has been on it for a while, and it's not really.
I saw you on Facebook with those
teeth. I know. She's only got a couple, and like, two that you can see, like, they stick out in this direction.
Crazy teeth of yours, and you got that big mass. It's going to come off.
She doesn't even care. She's
talking
to her, and she's just laying on the bed, just looking like, mm-hmm.
What in the world?
I'm happy right here.
Did I come during nap time?
I think
what?
So. Yeah.
Everyone's so quiet.
Everybody.
It's like going to the desert museum in the day.
Oh, yeah. Lucky.
Yeah.
You sure are lucky, loving up your bed. Oh, you're going to stare at me because I'm talking to you.
It's like you're sedated at all.
Oh. And who do you have here? Hi, how are you?
It's Conrad.
Conrad?
I think so, yep.
Aww. Hi, Conrad.
He's got a really weird thing on his tongue.
Oh, darn.
Yep.
Hey.
But not, doesn't mind about kissing. So. Yeah.
But yeah, they were telling me that they tried to like see him at the kennel at PAD, and she won't let him. Every time she tries to come to the front, she's not mean, but she just like puts her body against the kennel.
No,
P-A.
P-A,
so I thought maybe he showed up with a female dog and they named her mom. You know, mom. But no, it's just not like your one. He's just so smug. He likes the coach, but and he's so gentle. I didn't know about it. It almost looks like he's eating a car in a car.
Yeah.
He's tiny little nibbles because he's trying to find a sweeper. And once he finds a sweeper, he's already back.
We have a brand pup. He's a kitty mix. I think we raised daughter will send us videos. He's eating some corn on the top right now because they'll be doing something fun with it.
Yeah, it's always a choice. And he's a good boy. And he's a good boy. So they have him as a pimple. I'm just like, because he gets the wrinkles on his forehead, and it has not so much the fur on the top, like I was practicing yesterday, and you know how they have that like really coarse rough fur? That's
If you're looking on life, so I can see Mike come up here and see
him. I don't know. I think he's coming up.
And how old do you think he is?
They think he's six. I think he's probably about 4 or 5, honestly. He doesn't act like a man, but he does have a playful energy, but it's not like doing that.
Don, is that lucky? Storm?
So he came in.
He was in red there for a minute. Yeah.
So
his eyes are gone.
His little right cheek under his eye. So that's like one of my scars. That scar. I am. I do. So his kennel mate, they get along fine. She's kind of pushing dominant. So I would say that he does need to meet any other dogs in the home. Just because he, when he first got the pack, his public evaluation was kind of not been. I put him in this is what I call the Naughty Dog kennel, so it's like where the more obnoxious ones tend to be, like Fletcher was, and when Creed was still with us, like that's where this was that kennel because they're separated from the rest of them. It's a little easier to get them in and out, you know, for walks without them talking about the dog. And so, of all the new dogs that came up this week, I put him here based on his hair.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I love to hear your story.
It is
one dog. And then
yeah.
He ended up saying,
and
"Well, I'll take him."
Yeah, and he loved life with them. She says he never tries to leave. He's happy.
And the family that adopted him first, or whoever adopted him, was fine with that. But
yeah, we had a whole conversation. And he's like, he's his mom and dad were rescuer. That's what he. That's how he grew up. He's like early 20s. He's a good kid. He's a young guy. He's like, he might be a little bit more than what I can deal with right now. He
okay.
Said, and if they love him already, he said, "I'm okay with that." So that's. Yeah.
Just that, what a story.
Yeah. So it was pretty good. Oh, you gave me a look.
Okay, so the last thing I talked to you, gosh, it was probably a year ago. You said your volunteers typically come every week at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to be like subs or.
So we're going to be moving into our permanent location. Yeah.
Oh,
well, we knew it was going to happen when we moved here, but
yes,
I didn't think it was going to happen as fast. It didn't end up happening, so I figured we'd be here in 6 or 8 months. But, so we should have the means to follow me. Kind of the so,
where's that going
to be? It'll be Grant and Swan. It'll be the southeast corner of Grant and Swan, where the Trader Joe's and Test Mart. So we're going, once we're open and fully up and running.
Yeah. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah.
Then
so once we're fully up and running, we'll have a lot more time, like about 3 times that we have here. So we're going to have, and I'm probably going to be splitting the day into two shifts. So I know I have some volunteers who will come to them, you know, they'll be there so but folks will be able to volunteer with the AM or on the shift. So, so it'll be a little bit different. But it's going to be a bit. We're going to work towards that. I have to. It's not just time to go around again. Transporting 15 or more dogs every day is a lot. It's transporting 6 or 7 dogs every day. So there's a lot of moving parts to it.
Do you
Thursday and Friday, Subaru, Tucson, Dallas.
Because you have to hold to get out there.
No, so they actually, they have private day. One of their.
Why would it make your life easier?
Because if I had, because if I had been here, then on Saturdays and Sundays, I would not have.
No, I appreciate that. If I didn't.
Oh, and only Thursday and Friday.
Thursday and Friday.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it's really neat, and so they drive over to the morning, and I got, we have my shirt. And they come up here, and they have those up, and load back up to them, and then there's more volunteers that are on the course. So, yeah, it's a good system, but once you're expanded, it's gonna be a whole lot more. More vehicles to transport more dogs, which means more drivers, which means more people in the store, so it's.
This is pretty, did it fall down?
I've got two guys that load. Sunday, I've got another guy that helps them on Thursdays and Fridays. So yeah, it's a pretty consistent group, but that's